Manasi, how excited are you to host an event that is constituted by men for women?
See, it's wonderful. I think men and women are like yin and yang. We always go together. So I like the fact that Karan has started this, foundation that he's got, and this award that he gives out every year to different women. It's just wonderful, and I'm very happy and proud to be a part of this.
A line on women empowerment, since that is what it is all about.
I don't feel the need to be empowered. I am empowered, you know. I'm strongly of the belief that women do not need anybody to give them power. We come with this inherent power, this shakti, the stri shakti, the nari shakti. And I don't need anybody to give me anything. I'm powerful.
You are part of the TV industry, certain disorders. How the situation has changed and how the women are given opportunities and seen in the industry?
Right now, television is all about women. Actually, television has always been all about women, right from the beginning. At least Indian television, the central focus has always been women. There were very few male-oriented shows. In my career as an actor, I have done primarily work where the female was the central lead. So, yeah, I don't think we need any... we are good over there. We are well represented.
Okay, Manasi, how do you feel that many women look up to you and many women are inspired by you? The way you handle all the things,
I'm happy if I am able to inspire even one woman. And if you say that I inspire many, then I'm even more happy, because I think that's what all women should do. We inspire each other in various ways. You'll inspire me with something that you do. I'll inspire myself with something. And yeah.
Thank you.
Manasi, welcome. How excited are you to host an award function that is constituted by men for women?
Very excited. पहले शुरुआत में बताना चाहूँगी कि मेरा नाम मानसी नहीं है, मानसी है. दो अलग मीनिंग्स है शब्द के. मानसी का मतलब होता है आई थिंक प्लीजिंग टू द हार्ट एंड माइंड. मानसी का अर्थ है संपूर्ण नारी. सो नेक्स्ट टाइम व्हेन यू कॉल मी प्लीज रिमेंबर इट्स मानसी. यू नो इट्स ऑलवेज रियली रियली गुड टू बी अ पार्ट ऑफ एन इवेंट वेयर सो मेनी इंटरेस्टिंग वुमेन गेट टुगेदर, बिकॉज बातचीत इतनी वेरीड रहती है, इतने अलग अलग सब्जेक्ट्स पर बात कर रहे हैं. आई वॉज लुकिंग एट द पैनल दैट आई एम होस्टिंग टुडे. I've got a person with a computer background, a person with a fashion background. I've got a person with social services background. Itne vibhinn log hain aaj panel pe. It's always exciting because I always find the more women in a gathering, the more power there is.
Ma'am, what do you know about the foundation, Karan sir, running the foundation for education?
Karan is a very very old friend of mine. Mujhe lagta hai ki jo bhi log thoda bahut नॉन गवर्नमेंट ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस और फाउंडेशंस के साथ अपना टाइम लगाते हैं तो दे नीड टू बी अपलॉडेड कमेंडेड. हालांकि मैं आई एम नॉट दैट, दिस इज माय फर्स्ट टाइम विद करण एट द फाउंडेशन, सो आई हैव लर्नड अ लॉट अबाउट इट टुडे विद द स्क्रिप्ट. बट आई थिंक इट्स अ फैंटास्टिक इनिशिएटिव एंड एनी टाइम एनीबडी इज बीइंग ऑनर्ड फॉर द वर्क दैट दे बीन डूइंग, आई थिंक इट्स अ स्टेप फॉरवर्ड इन द राइट डायरेक्शन. इट ब्रिंग्स पीपल क्लोजर टुगेदर. सो ऑल द वेरी बेस्ट टू करण फॉर हिज फाउंडेशन. आई थिंक इट्स अ फैंटास्टिक इनिशिएटिव.
Clear? Can you hear me loud and clear?
Yeah. Hello guys.
Karan sir, what should I buy you? What has inspired you to start the foundation and do the work?
So, thank you very much all of you all for being here today. I Am Woman is an initiative by the Karan Gupta Education Foundation and IE Business School. We've started the foundation more than 19 years ago, and our work was mainly with underprivileged women and children. Because when we used to go to schools and we used to pay for the children's education, we realized that while parents would always find the funds for the little boys, there were never funds left for the girls. And so we started a whole program and initiative towards women empowerment. Even with the handicapped people that we worked with, there's a discrimination between male and female handicapped people. And we wanted to do something for them. So our skill development programs, all of them are for women and of course handicapped men as well. But one of the reasons why we started an I Am Woman empowerment movement is to change the perception and to try to give women more power.
So what are supporters right now at the moment, and what was the challenge you started the foundation and right now what is the challenge you are facing?
I'm sorry, can you?
What is the challenge you are facing, you know, running the foundation?
So, well, the foundation works a lot with women and children from different backgrounds. I think one challenge that we face is to get more people to join as volunteers. We are always looking to make an outreach to a lot more people. We started a self-defense program where we go into the slums and we teach little children how to defend themselves, because after the child rape cases, we wanted to make sure that children are empowered and children have the power to defend themselves. So one challenge that we face is try to get more people excited about our initiative, try to get more people actually involved with us. Thank you.
So,
center. So this year we have a very, very diverse range of women being felicitated and awarded. We have a panel, and the panel is from women in business, women in arts. We have Keisha Gupta, who is the head of learning at Infosys, Deepika Gehani, who is the co-founder of Genesis Luxury. We have Priya Kumar, who's an author. And who else do we have on the business panel? On the business panel, we have, who's our fourth person? Why am I forgetting our fourth person on the business panel? Ah, and the most important, we have Nita Lulla, who is a designer and entrepreneur. And then, of course, our chief guest for the evening is Sonali Bendre, a woman who really, really has inspired millions of people around the world, a woman who still is positive, still is a message of hope, courage, and strength. We have Dr. Sindhutai Sapkal, a mother who abandoned her own children to be mother to 1,400 orphans. We have a burn survivor who started an NGO just to help others like her. We also have a lawyer who fought the Kathua rape case, and despite having death threats to her life, she still fought for what is right. So these are the kind of women we are awarding tonight.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Karan sir, I mean, wonderful initiative recognizing the women who are successful in their respective fields. What can I say about that?
It's a wonderful, wonderful event, wonderful way of recognizing the women today. We are all working at par with the men, and I think it's more tough for a woman because she has to manage the house and organization. It's like we work like a well-oiled machinery, which doesn't even get a chance to for maintenance. So and women today are empowered and walking hand in hand with the man, and I think we have a long way to go. Thank you.
So at 15 you have a big business venture. Tell us about the venture.
So the IA venture was the biggest experience of my life, where judges scoring me and I'm speaking with standing and speaking and saying my business idea. So my business idea, which I name it Basket of Joy, it is basically about fruit basket online company, which I help low community people like sex workers, farmers, disabled people. So I source my baskets from sex workers in Kamatipura and Kashmiri women, and the organic fruits from farm in Pune. And I source, there will be an envelope which is made by disabled people, and the products are going to be delivered by miracle couriers who are deaf and tone. So this is my idea, and I won the social impact prize and I got the 50,000 rupees to start my business.
The idea kahan se hai aapko 15 saal ki umar mein?
So I wanted to support my family financially, and I wanted to make sure that my sister receives excellent education. Even I have came from low background, so I thought of this idea where I can employ them and they can earn some money and they can live their happier life.
Thank you. What about the I Am Woman initiative started by Karan sir? You know, I mean, how wonderful is the initiative? As many women are recognized for their success and their effort.
I think it's an amazing place to be right now, especially for women. I think women should help each other and also support one another.
How when we talk about women empowerment, right? We talk about constitution, we talk about directive principles of state policy, we talk about laws. One government puts a woman in the house, says we are there to protect you, and the government falls, the other one comes, you vacate, without even thinking that directive is against her. I'm called an anti-national. Look, do I look like an anti-national? Do I look like an anti-national? Have you heard about me earlier before 2018 that she was an agent of RAW, or she was an agent for some national agency? No, I'm being called, I'm being tagged. My daughter will be again said that she was an agent of a she is a daughter of an agent. This is what our Samaj is all about. I'm tendering apology. But most of us are like this without confirming the facts. I've seen the media stories without taking my quote, without confirming things from me, without consulting a senior criminal lawyer, a public prosecutor, she has been dumped. Without knowing that a private lawyer cannot pursue a criminal case. This is how you are outraging someone's modesty. Outraging modesty is not only touching the body. Outraging modesty is outraging the character of a person also. Right? So this is all our samaj is about. This is how we talked about. We only, you know, we are paper tigers. Am I right? Angrezi mein. Sirf baat karte hain hum log. Implement nahi karte kanun ko. The day we start implementing the law with our strong will, I'm sure, hum log women empowerment ki baat nahi karenge. Right? So today, I'm at a threshold where I'm being told to vacate. Trust me, I swear on everything around me. Jo bhi mujhe bahut zyada pyara hai, I'm not getting a house in Jammu. You know why? Because of the false media trial. No one holds the responsibility of covering facts. The other day I went to see a house because I really don't want to have the possession of the government house. I really want to vacate. I'm not getting that peace there. Peace is more important than anything else. I'm not getting that peace there. But I need to have a place wherein I can put. I went to the governor of my state. He has blocked my number. Just imagine a governor of the state blocking my number and no one. Why would he block my number? Just imagine why. Just because I went to him and said, sir, hamesha ke liye allot mat karo, saal ke liye allot karo, so that the narrative is changed and I get a proper place to be in with my daughter. He blocked my number. Maybe he was not fed well about me. And there is no mechanism to confirm the facts. There is no mechanism used by them to know about a person. This is how we talk about women empowerment. And this is how, like, an activist is an anti-national, a politician is a nationalist. So I plan to join politics.
Okay. Wow. I need a second now. You know, I think, ma'am, the problem in this country and nowadays in the world in general is that you're guilty until proven innocent. It's no longer the way it used to be. So all I can say on behalf of everyone in this room is more power to you. We're all standing by you, and I'm sure there are millions and millions of people, especially young girls out there who look up to you, who probably don't have the courage to stand up.
I have a message for everyone.
Yes. Absolutely. We want a nice message.
I have a message for women, everyone over here and outside. Please, please go on. That little girl who came to this place and was interviewed by Rohit. Rohit, I'm a big fan of yours and your wife also. I've been seeing all of you on TV. Nahi, I love you both. she is gonna be my inspiration. I swear, she has inspired me so much, so much. I work on domestic violence also. I come across cases where women are beaten up, treated with cruelty, not treated well in their matrimonial homes. So there are a lot of cases. So even sex workers, you see women who have faced violence. I wanted to work for them and wanted to start something which gives them.
Sonali Bendre, you're an actress, a mother, and a cancer survivor.
Yeah.
could you please tell us a little bit about your journey being an actor and a mother?
Well, acting was a job, it was a profession. I never expected to be an actor, but I came to love the job that I did. And I fell in love with that profession. I think that acting is what has made me, whatever I am today, it came from there. And I found my family there also. I met my husband there. Dated him. I mean, at that point of time, he was my boyfriend, and then we got married. And so I have a family from the same profession. So this profession has not just given me the material and the like the money aspect of it, but I did find a family here also. So there's a lot of connection and there's a lot of bonding, I would say, where acting is concerned. As a mother, well, what can I say? one of the most wonderful feelings. I think it's an ongoing process, and all I can say as a mother is that I hope I get it right. Fingers are crossed, prayers are hard. That's about it. What else can you say?
That's amazing. So, Sonali, what led you to being an author?
my parenting, you know, what I went through, and when I was looking at the things that I was going through to understand how to bring my child up, and I realized that it was such a unique journey that I had to document it. And you know, so when I wrote the book, I've always said that I used to have this little book in which I would write down all the things that were my insights into it, and my friends were like, you know, listen, you need to write a book on this. And so if the book I wrote was also, it was not about this is the way, it was more about my journey. I just wrote about my journey because I think everybody has their own unique journey where parenting is concerned. I mean, if you have two children, both are different, so there's nothing, there's no formula to it. But certain things over the ages don't change, and certain things keep changing and are personal. So
my scarf and gloves, and he said, you're unfit. Vihari, you started the Burn Survivor Trust,
yes,
which is doing very good work, and you are doing helping others. Tell us a little about that.
Yeah.
Why I'm starting this BSMS? Because of my personal experience. When I face the problem, my skills is working, not my beauty. The first thing. And the second thing is, birth survivor needs physical support and especially surgical support. Because of lack of awareness and because of financial problems, they are not aware of these surgeons. And we have so many government hospitals and so many plastic surgeons. Generally, plastic surgeons means it's very expensive treatment, and this is related to only beauty. But people doesn't know about only plastic surgeons are treating these kind of burns and reconstructive surgeries. So my father faced the same problem, financial problem. So why should I start this surgical support to burn survivors? They are losing their identity and they are not getting it. So till now, in this span of 3 years, I conducted four surgical camps in AP and Telangana, recently Kerala states. We did 70 plus plastic surgeries, completely free of cost, and more than 600 counselings.
Wonderful. Big round of applause, everybody, for Nihari Mandan. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for sharing your journey with us and proving an inspiration to everybody.
Yeah. And before leaving, I want to say one thing. Treat us like a normal human beings. We are just physically burned, not mentally. And before your journey, a burn survivor, try to burn your fingertip first, after that judge us. Acid attacks are getting lots of support. This is not for controversy, these are the facts. Acid attacks are getting support from society and everywhere, but burn survivors are not getting. These statistics are very high, and the government also released 2,930 crores National Program Against Burn Injuries. But there is no proper awareness. We need all your support to create awareness about burns. And the first thing we are asking, treat us like a normal human beings first. And after that, we'll lead our life in our own way. We don't want anybody's support. Just we need freedom in our society. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Manasi, and thank you, Nihari. Very, very inspiring story. I'd like to invite onto stage a model, an actor, a director, an entrepreneur, and has worked in several Bollywood films, including Khosla Ka Ghosla, My Name Is Khan, and Monsoon Wedding, for which he won critical acclaim. He's a trained scuba diver and underwater photographer as well. He recently encouraged startups and students who want to be entrepreneurs through his talk at the IE Venture Day. Before we welcome onto stage Parveen Dabas, I'd like to play an AV. Are we playing an AV or is it just a card? Ladies and gentlemen, first I'd like to call on the stage Parveen Dabas and hand it over to you. Yes, any one of these.
Thank you for the lovely introduction. You can send my personal AV home later. And thank you, Karan.
उतरने के बाद जब हमारे मराठी लोग मिलने को आते हैं, जोर से चिल्लाते हैं, जय महाराष्ट्र, हमारा नववारी देश, जय महाराष्ट्र. मेरे पति रो रहे थे, मेरे को अच्छा लग रहा था, मगर भाई का कलेजा कैसा होता है. अंदर से आवाज आई, गलती कर रही है, होता है उन्होंने नहीं छोड़ा होता तो इतनी बड़ी होती. माफ कर दे, अपन माफ करते, इसीलिए अपनों को माई बोलते हैं, माँ बोलते हैं. मैं पति के पास गई, उसका हाथ मेरे हाथ में लिया, थोड़ा सा दबा भी लिया. मैं बोली, बहती गंगा है, लेव चांस. फिर तो वो और जोर से रोने लगे. मैं बोली, ब्याह सकट हो. फिर मैंने उसकी आंख पूछे और उसको बताया, रो रहे आप, जब आपने मेरे को छोड़ा था तो मैं रो रही थी, अभी तुम रो रहे. कोई किसी का नहीं होता. जब तक गाल पे घोस तब तक यार भी दोस, गाल पे घोस हट जाए तो यार भी टूट जाए. ये दिल भी मेरा समंदर था, सिर्फ प्यार का पानी था उसमें, मगर आज हो तूफान उठ आया है, सागर को पता नहीं किनारा किधर है. दूध में पकाए चावल तो उसे खीर कहते हैं, मोहब्बत में खाए ठोकर तो उसे तकदीर कहते हैं. लकीर की फकीर हूँ मैं, उसका कोई गम नहीं, नहीं धन तो क्या हुआ, इज्जत तो मेरी कम नहीं. मैंने अपने पल्लू से उसकी आंख पूछा और उसको बताया, रो रहे क्या बात है, तुमने मेरे को हकला तब मेरे पुल्ले में गाठी थी, आप तुम्हारे धोती में है ना, 50-50 इधर उधर. अभी यहाँ रोते मत, बैठो, थकते तुम, अभी मेरे पास चलो. क्यों, आपने नहीं छोड़ा होता तो मैं मर जाती कब के.
अभी आपकी सेवा की संधि दो, मेरे मैं बड़ी बन गई इसलिए आपका अधिकार है वो। मगर एक बात है, पति बन के मत आना, मैं पत्नी नहीं होना चाहती। मगर हमारे मराठी के तुकाराम महाराज बोलते हैं कि पत्नी क्षणाची अनंत काळाची माता है, बच्चा बन के आते क्या? पति नहीं, बच्चा बन के आते। मैं आपकी भी माँ होना चाहती हूँ। वो पर्सन उठा के लाया ना मैंने मेरे घर, हाँ वो उठाया और डाला गाड़ी में, धाड़ धूड़ और वॉच करने का नहीं। और बच्चों को बोला बेटा इन्होंने मेरे को नहीं छोड़ा होता तुमको माँ मिलते रहे, देने घेने 50-50 बेटा, उन्होंने तुमको माँ दिया, अभी उनका रिश्तेदार तुम बनो, अभी उनकी सेवा तुम करो। 5 साल मेरे बच्चे ने उसकी सेवा की, अभी गए बरस